Welcome, and thank you for watching this video tutorial about systemic lupus erythematosus, SLE. If we look at each of the three words, we can remember what this disorder refers to. Systemic tells us it affects multiple organs. Lupus is Latin for wolf, and erythematosus refers to reddening of the skin and was so named after the characteristic red butterfly rash over the nose and cheeks that resembles a wolf's snout. SLE is an autoimmune chronic inflammatory connective tissue disorder that affects multiple body systems and occurs predominantly in young women. It primarily affects the skin, joints, and kidneys, but every organ of the body can be affected. Like many autoimmune diseases, it is difficult to determine why it develops, but it is often due to genetics and the environment. Susceptibility genes plus environmental risk factors, for example, a sunburn, can cause damage to cell DNA, causing cell death, exposing the inside of the cell, including parts of the nucleus such as DNA, histones, and other proteins, to the rest of the body. Because the individual is more susceptible, their immune cells are more likely to think these parts of the cells are foreign or antigens, and they attack them. The body has a buildup to these nuclear antigens, and the body forms anti-nuclear antibodies that attach themselves to the antigens. These antigen-antibody complexes enter the bloodstream and get deposited into blood vessel walls, organs, and tissues such as the skin, kidneys, heart, and joints, which cause inflammation. When this tissue damage occurs, it is known as type 3 hypersensitivity reaction. Environmental triggers include UV radiation, viruses, bacteria, sex hormones such as estrogen, smoking, and medications such as procainamide, hydralazine, and isoniazid. Lupus is about 10 times more common in women during reproductive years than men. The inflammation is what causes the symptoms seen in lupus. Diagnosis is difficult because the symptoms vary greatly between individuals. There are the typical general symptoms, such as fever, joint pain, rash, and weight loss, and specific symptoms that depend on what organ or tissue is being affected. The American College of Rheumatology has developed criteria for the diagnosis of SLE, which uses a point system based on the severity of the symptom. Symptoms include fever, skin-related symptoms, such as a red butterfly rash, also called malar rash, on the face, a discoid rash, which is the plaque-like red patch that can scar, photosensitivity, which causes other rashes from sun exposure, non-scarring alopecia, and ulcers in the mucous membrane of the mouth or nose. The main joint-related symptom is arthritis or inflammation of two or more joints and 30 minutes of morning stiffness. Symptoms in the serosa or outer membrane of tissue may include serositis or inflammation of the serous membrane around the lungs, heart, or other organ. Neurologic symptoms include migraine headaches, seizures, stroke, and psychosis. Symptoms related to the blood depend on the cells being attacked and include anemia when red blood cells are being attacked and leukopenia when white blood cells are being attacked or thrombocytopenia when platelets are being attacked. Symptoms affecting the kidneys include proteinuria, nephritis, and glomerulonephritis. An immunologic disorder is seen with a positive finding of antibodies in the blood, including anti-nuclear antibodies or other autoantibodies. Other symptoms often seen with SLE include Raynaud phenomena, when fingers and toes turn very pale or bluish when exposed to cold. Also, nausea, diarrhea, abdominal pain, liver damage, pancreatitis, and repeated miscarriages in obstetrical patients. Symptoms of lupus are exhibited by flare-ups and then periods of remittance. It is important to teach patients the need for preventing flare-ups by doing such things such as avoiding sun exposure, proper skin care, avoiding sources of infection, and reducing stress. Surgery and pregnancy can also trigger flare-ups. In most cases, if the initial inflammation is controlled, the long-term prognosis is good. SLE should be classified as mild or severe. Mild symptoms including fever, arthritis, headache, rash, and severe symptoms include hemolytic anemia, large pleura, and pericardial involvement. significant renal damage, and complicated CNS involvement, among others. The most common presenting symptoms in mild SLE include arthritis and arthralgia, and can be usually controlled by NSAIDs. Regardless of disease severity, the anti-malaria drug hydroxychloroquine is indicated for all SLE patients because it decreases flares and mortality. In severe disease, corticosteroids and immunosuppressants are given to limit the immune response. Chronic disease should be treated with the lowest dose of corticosteroids and anti-inflammatories that will maintain remission. Treatment is also based on the patient's presenting clinical symptoms. During flare-ups, patients with SLE are acutely ill, and the nurse focuses his care on the symptoms presented. The nurse should monitor for renal dysfunction and the effects of medications. Neurologic status must be frequently assessed for the development of cognitive dysfunction resulting from the disease process or steroid therapy. Okay, let's go over a few questions to review. A 30-year-old woman has been diagnosed with systemic lupus erythematosus, SLE, and would like to become pregnant. When teaching the patient about the disease, the nurse should include which of the following? Choose all that apply. Number one. SLE is a hereditary disorder of women that usually shows clinical symptoms when a woman becomes pregnant. Number two, SLE is a disease that causes an inflammatory response because antibodies bind with estrogen receptors. Number three, SLE is an autoimmune disorder that has an extremely variable course with no way to predict its progression. Or number four, SLE often causes miscarriages, therefore, she should consult a high-risk obstetrician to carefully consider the safety of medications used for treatment during pregnancy. If you chose number three and four, you're correct. Women are more at risk for SLE, but it's not confined just to women, and clinical symptoms may worsen during pregnancy, but are also evident prior to pregnancy. Here's another. A nurse is taking a health assessment of a patient who complains of a low-grade fever, fatigue, joint pain, muscle pain, and photosensitivity. SLE is suspected, and the nurse would check for which of the following signs that occurs with SLE. Number one, ascites. Number two, polycythemia. Number three, red butterfly rash across the cheeks and nose. Number four, bronchi. If you chose number three, you're right. A red butterfly rash across the face is a classic sign of SLE. And lastly, the pathophysiology of SLE involve number one, overproduction of collagen that affects internal organs. Number two, the body producing various autoantibiotics that attack parts of the cell nucleus. Number three, abnormal IgG complexes that cause inflammation. Or number four, immunodeficiency caused by increased activity of T cells and decreased activity of B cells. If you chose number two, you're correct. In SLE, the body produces many autoantibodies that are directed against parts of the cell nucleus, particularly DNA. Antigen antibody complexes form and enter the bloodstream, getting deposited in blood vessel walls, organs, tissues, which causes inflammation. Thank you for watching this video about systemic lupus erythematosus, SLE. Hope this helps you with your studying. Be sure to like and subscribe. Check out our other videos.